Baat, we're fortunate to have with us Anika Parasharji, is the CEO of Fortis Lafa, and she is one of the panelists here at National Menstrual Conclave, a first of its kind. And she has also worked a lot on menstrual hygiene and awareness. Ma'am, will you tell us what brought you to this event and what was the key message that you had from your panel discussion?
What brought me here is that I've, as an organization, we've tapped into the fact that there is not enough conversation happening around menstruation,
right,
around menstrual health. Women don't feel that they have spaces to come in to talk to doctors, experts, counselors on the various issues, emotional and physical, that they're going through during their menstruation and during the start of menstruation. So, as an organization, Fortis Lafa has taken a very conscious and active decision to start adolescent camps all over the country to work with young girls and their parents on actually making the whole process of menstruation a lot more a lot more focused, a lot more where they can actually talk about the issues that are on their mind, where they can air their worries, their concerns, and where they can get the support that they need.
So before I come to the accessibility question, or the accessibility of all these campaigns, one very interesting thing that you were mentioning as a speaker was the entire psychology around the genitalization of women, how they are just reduced to their genitals and the understanding in the dignity of women in our
person. Actually, I wasn't talking about the reduction of their dignity at all, not what I said. I said that women's health till now has been looked at as reproductive health, to do with obstetrics.
Yes.
So that there is a lot of dignity in that. So don't, please don't misunderstand what was said there.
A feminist perspective also has problems with just looking at them as reproductive machines.
Yeah.
So,
So that I'm not commenting on, that's a whole different discussion.
Right.
And I am a subtle feminist. So I think what I'm trying to say is that Fortis Lafa focuses on all aspects of women's health, not just obstetrics. And so that's what our focus area is for the coming years. We've repositioned ourselves. We're no longer just an obstetric set of hospitals. We look after everything to do with women and child health. And this step towards adolescent and menopause clinics and focusing on other life stages of the women, women's life, other than the time when she's becoming a mother, is a very, as I said, active, very well thought out strategic decision on our part in terms of addressing a need gap which exists for women in this country.
Yeah. So coming to the need aspect and the accessibility aspect, you know that millions of women, or the urban informal sector women who are working, do not have access to clean shelter itself, and the idea of awareness there is much distant. So how do we address that, and how do we ensure that those weaker sections also get accessibility to such campaigns the way you are running them?
So hopefully as more partners join hands together, this is a great initiative, this conference in its own right, to be able to get people talking, to be able to get people to associate on the same same cause. Everyone can do what's within their bandwidth. We as a healthcare provider will definitely do whatever we can. If we join hands with other partners who have similar goals to us, we can actually reach out to more people, provide full access, provide education, get our doctors to actually go out there and fill up gaps. So there are a lot of things that we can do as a combined force.
Yes. One final question: what is the greatest challenge that you have encountered in this endeavor towards spreading awareness among women and children? Finally, about Sachi Saheli initiatives like these, how can they help in this entire endeavor?
So I think Sachi Saheli has taken a great step in the right direction. The first step, by organizing this kind of conference, I think a lot of people who are like-minded who have very strong views about bettering the situation for menstrual health in the country have come together, and that I think is a great first initiative. Now it's about us actually following up, and working together to be able to take this to the next level.
Thank you so much for joining, Janaki Bhatia. It was a pleasure.
Thank you.
Thank you.